Hello students, I thought you very well understand the basics of the integers and the properties of the integers related to addition and subtraction. Alright, the two worksheets I'll give to you previously, both are related to addition and the subtraction. Next, come towards the multiplication of the integers and its property. How we can multiply the integers, the positive integers, the negative integers, or one positive, one negative, and so on. Let us start first point. Why multiplying a positive integer and a negative integer, we multiply them as a whole numbers. What does it mean by the whole numbers? Whole numbers mean we are not related with the sign. We just multiply the digits only. Next, and put a minus sign before the product. Thus, we get a negative integer. Read one more time. While multiplying a positive integer and a negative integer, we multiply them as a whole numbers and put a minus sign before the product. Thus, we get a negative integer. So, when we multiply one positive, one negative integer in any order, we get a negative integer. Alright, now for understand this, let us see the rule first. Let A and B are the two integers. Alright, then what happened? If A is multiplied with the minus B or minus A multiplied with B, what happened there? Then negative sign is placed outside. Means if plus sign is multiplied with the negative sign, what is the result? We get a negative sign. Alright, next, if negative sign is multiplied with plus sign, what we get? That we get a negative sign. That you can more understand from first video in which I told you about the multiplication of the signs. And the numbers are multiplied. Numbers are multiplied as whole numbers. As whole numbers in which all numbers are positive, you have to multiply the numbers. But you must remember the sign. How we place the sign in front of the multiplication of two numbers. For example, if 3 is multiplied with 4, what we get? We get 12. Alright, now 3 is positive, 4 is positive. So we get a positive result. If two positive integers are multiplied, the result is again a positive integers. Now, let us see the example. First integer is plus 5, second integer is minus 6. So what we get here? The result is minus 30. How we get this result? With the help of this rule. This rule told about that when we multiply a positive integer with a negative integer, the result is negative. Why? Because the positive sign multiplied with negative sign gives us a negative sign. And the numbers are multiplied separately. So 5 into 6, we get 30. So answer is a negative integer. Similarly, one more example to relate these two terms, in which first integer is negative, that is minus 2. And second integer is positive, that is plus 7. When we multiply two integers, one negative and one positive, what happened? Result is a negative integer. Answer is negative. And we have to multiply 2 into 7. What we get? Result is 14. So in both the cases, if one integer is negative, maybe at the second place or maybe at the first place, result is always negative. Alright. So, I thought you understand how we can multiply the integers. We have to multiply integers like a whole number. But you must remember the sign in front of the integers. Now, next part is, why multiplying two negative integers? Now, in this case, we have to multiply one positive and one negative. But in this case, what we have to do? The two negative integers means the both integers are negative. We multiply them as a whole numbers and put a positive sign before the product. Means when negative integer is multiplied with negative integer, we get a positive sign. So if A and b are two integers, then minus a multiply minus b, we get result is plus a into b. When no sign is placed in front of the integers, so it means it is positive integers. Alright, now let us see one example. Minus 5 is multiplied with minus 7. So we have to multiply two negative integer. We multiply them as a whole number. Whole number means 5 is multiplied with 7. What we get? 35. And put a positive sign before the product. So we have to place a positive sign before the product. Next, the product of 3 or more negative integer. In this case, we only take 2 integers at a time. Now, if more than 2 integers come together and all are negative, what happened then for the sign and for the numbers? Now, I take the example of only one. Why? Because I have taken such kind of examples. You can see when minus 1 is multiplied with minus 1, both are negative similar integers. When 1 is multiplied with 1, our result is always 1. I want to concentrate on the sign. Okay, first you understand the sign, then we can take more example. When 1 is multiplied with 1, answer is always 1. Maybe 2 times, maybe 3 times, maybe 4 times, maybe 5 times. The result is always 1. You must understand this thing first. Next come towards the positive and the negative sign. You can see here, when we multiply two negative integer, our result is positive. As you can understand from this concept, the result is positive. But when I multiply three negative integers, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. So negative integers, when three negative integers multiply, the result is negative. Alright, why this result is negative? You can understand from this concept also. Negative and negative. When two integers multiply, we get a positive sign. Alright, so we get a positive sign from these two integers. Alright, and when a positive sign is multiplied with negative sign, we get again a negative sign. This result is used here. Understand? Alright, next, come towards four negative integers. When minus 1 is multiplied with minus 1, minus 1 and minus 1, we take 4 times. So when 1 is multiplied 4 times, result is always 1, as you know. Next is, how we get a positive sign when we multiply the 4 negative integers? You can understand from this concept, when we multiply 2 negative integers, what we get? A positive sign. Now, we get a positive sign from first 2 negative integers. And we get a positive sign from last 2 negative integers. We can put them in pairs. One positive sign from first 2 integer and one positive sign from second 2 and third and fourth integers. When two positive signs multiply together, we get a positive sign. Now, you can understand from these concepts that you can make a pairs of the integers for multiplication, for 3 or more multiplication. I'll give you one more clue how you can remember that positive sign come or negative sign come. Now see one more result from this. Let us read the result. If the number of negative integer in a product is even, if the numbers of negative integers, numbers of negative integers means here we have taken two negative integers. Here we have taken three negative integers. Now, the number of negative integers in a product is even. Even means if we are going to take two negative integers or we have taken four negative integers, these are even numbers. Even means 2, 4 which are divisible by 2. Even, you very well know about the even numbers. So when we multiply two negative integers or we multiply four negative integers, you can understand from this, if number of negative integer in a product is even, then the product is a positive integer. Means you can see from these results, we get two results are positive and two results are negative. Why these two results are positive? Because when we multiply two negative integer or four negative integer, or you can take six negative integers, means even number of negative integer, the result is always positive integer. Next, and if number of negative integer in a product is odd, what does it mean? Odd means we have to multiply 3 negative integer at a time or 5 negative integer at a time, because they are odd number 3, 5 and 7. We get result is negative. You can see from these examples. If number of negative integer in a product is odd, then product is negative, result is negative. So we can conclude, or we can remember by this method also, that when we multiply two negative integers in the even format means when we take two negative integers, 2 or 4 or 6, their counting is even, their numbers are even. Alright, the digits can be take anything else, 7, 5, 6, anything else, but their counting 1, 2, 3, 4 is even, we get positive result. If their counting is odd, like 3 or 5 negative integers, the result is negative. Let us see two more example to understand this. When I want to multiply minus 4 with minus 3, these are two negative integers. One is minus 4 and second is minus 3. In counting, they are 2. So, they are even in counting. So, when we multiply these two negative integers, result is positive. 3 multiply 4, result is plus 12. When I want to multiply minus 4 with minus 3 with minus 2. Now, total integers are 3. So, in counting, they are odd. So, we get a negative answer. And we have to multiply 4 with 3 and with 2 then. So, result is minus 24. Student, I thought you understand about the integers. That how the integers are multiplied, how the positive integers are multiplied, how the negative integers are multiplied. Now, next are the properties of the multiplication of the integers. Previously, we have done the properties of addition and subtraction of the integers. Now, we have to understand how the properties related to addition and subtraction also used for the multiplication of the integers. Now, let us start with first property we also used for the addition and the subtraction. Alright, the first is closer property, closer under multiplication. Means the closer property is also used for multiplication of the integer. Whether this property is satisfied by this operation of the mathematics, multiplication of the mathematics satisfy closer property or not. Let us understand. Integers are closed under multiplication. What I have to write here, integers are closed under multiplication means integers jo hai wo closed hai multiplication se related. And what is closer property? Closer property told that when any two integers multiply, as we understand from the addition and subtraction previous video, closer property told that when we apply any mathematical operation on any two integers, result is again an integers. Let us understand from this. So, rule is what? So, for all the integers a and b, a multiplied b is also an integers. For example, 4 multiplied 3 is equal to 12. 4 is a positive integer. 3 is also a positive integer. When we multiply these two integers, what is the result? That is plus 12. So, we get result is plus 12 and that is also a positive integers. So, integers are closed for the multiplication. You can take more example. You can take one positive, one negative or both negative integer. Result is always an integer. So, we can say for all integers, whether positive, both negative or one positive, one negative, a multiplied b is an integer. So, closer property hold good or closer property satisfied by the multiplication of the integer. Next property is commutative property. What is commutative property? Commutative property used for addition and subtraction previously. In that we have understand that what is the commutative property. Commutative property means when we interchange the position of the integers. When we interchange the position of the integers with any mathematical operation, means the addition and subtraction for the integers, the integers are commutative. Similarly for the multiplication. Multiplication is commutative for integers. Let us see this happen or not happen. So for any two integers a and b, rule is a multiply b is equal to b multiply a. You can understand from this that we have to multiply two integers in a different order. In this, at first position a placed, at second position b placed, and in this case at first position b and second position is filled by a. So when we interchange the positions, the results are similar. For example, let us take two integers. One is negative integer, that is minus 2. Other is positive integer, that is 3. When we multiply these two integers, we get the result is minus 6. Now let us see, the same result is happen when we interchange the positions. You can understand from this, when I have interchanged the position, you can see 3 is now at first position and minus 2 is at the second position. What happened to the result? Result is again minus 6. How this result happened? Now how did we get this result? 2 is multiplied with 3, result is 6. 3 is multiplied with 2, result is 6. 1 negative, 1 positive, result is negative. 1 positive, 1 negative, result is negative. So we get the similar result after interchanging the positions. That is first and second position interchange and we get the same result. So commutative property satisfied by the multiplication of the integer. That's why we can say multiplication is commutative for the integers. Now come towards third very important property, associative property for the integers using multiplication. Now multiplication is associative for the integers. How multiplication is associative and what is associative property? I thought you understand the associative property for addition and subtraction. In associative property, we have to select three integers at a time and we have to group them, group in a different manner to solve. Let us see same for the multiplication. Now, let us see first of all one example. Now, let us see from this side, one integer is minus 3, second integer is minus 4 and third integer is 2. Alright, now when we want to multiply these three integers, let us group them. Group them in, for to prove associative property. First of all, I'll make a group of first and second integer. Minus 3 is multiplied with minus 4, then multiplied with 2. Alright, when minus 3 is multiplied with the minus 4, what is the result? What we get here? The result is 12. 12 positive. Why 12 positive? When 3 is multiplied with 4, we get result is 12. When negative sign is multiplied with negative sign, I told you, no? That when two negative integers are multiplied, result is positive. So 3 multiplied 4, result is 12. And then we have to multiply with the 2, the third integer, that is positive 2. We get a result is 24. Now, these three integers do not change their place. Alright, that is at the first position, this at the second position, now this is at the third position. Alright, now we have to select now second and third to multiply first. Okay, now minus 4 is multiplied with 8. 1 negative, 1 positive, result is negative. 4 is multiplied with 2, we get 8. and then this result is multiplied with minus 3. The negative sign is multiplied with the negative sign. Result is positive sign. And 8 multiplied 3, we get result is 24. Now you can understand, when we select a different pairing, you can see here a different pairing for the multiplication, but the result is overall similar. That is, result is 24 in both the cases. And this happens only because multiplication is associative for the integer. So for any three integers, A, B and C, any integer either positive or negative, or one positive, second negative, A multiply B multiply C by pairing first and second, and we have to pair here second and third. Their results are similar. We can multiply in any pattern, results are similar. That's why the multiplication is associative. I thought you understand the three properties. Multiplication are closed under integers are closed under multiplication. Integers are commutative for the multiplications. Integers are associative for the multiplication. Integers satisfy all these three properties. Next, multiplication by zero. Now let us revise this property. I thought you know very well about this property. Multiplication of any integer and a zero, result is always a zero. When we multiply any number, either positive or negative or both negative, result is zero. So for any integer A, so rule is, for any integer A, when A is multiplied with zero in any pattern or in any pairing, like first position is filled by integer at second place zero. In this case, first place is filled by zero and second place is filled by any integer, result is always zero. For example, 3 is a positive integer. When I am multiplying 3 with 0 or 0 at the first place, you can select any place, but when 0 is multiplied with any integer, we have taken example of 3, you can take any example, result is always 0. So I thought you understand all the four properties related to integers. Integers are closed under multiplication. Integers are commutative for the multiplication. Integers are associative for the multiplication. And next, multiplication with the zero, because zero is also an integer. So you must write this property also. Multiplication by zero to any integer, we get result is always zero. So I thought, student, you understand all these properties. Next, we have to discuss more properties of the integers. All right.